As you know that the refraction, in refraction, the light move from one medium to another medium. Then the bending of light takes place. The bending of light, when it moves from one medium to another medium, that is known as refraction. And we have to draw the laws of refraction on the basis of wave theory. The laws of refraction mean, number one, the incident ray, refracted ray and normal lie in the same plane. And the second law being sin I upon sin r equal to constant, that is refractive index. The ratio of sine of angle of incidence to sine of angle of refraction is a constant, and that is the refractive index of denser medium with respect to wavelength medium. Now for this purpose, again we take the three light ray. We take this angle as small in compared to the laws of reflection. The three light ray, that is 1, 2 and 3, strike the boundary of two medium, M1. This is real medium and this is denser medium. Boundary of two medium at angle I. This angle is I. This is 90 minus I and this angle becomes I. This is 9 I. So this is 90 minus I because rays are perpendicular to wavefront. This is 90 minus I. Whole, this is normal. Poor angle 90 and so this angle becomes 90 minus 90 minus I. That is I. The particle ABC oscillate in the same phase, so they form a plane wavefront. And according to Huygens' principle, each of the particle act like new source emit the secondary wavelets. And the secondary wavelet started from A, strike the boundary of two medium after time t and a cover distance c1t, where c1 is the speed of light in first medium. And you know that distance is equal to speed into time. While the secondary wavelets started from B, move in the denser medium, and that in denser medium the speed will be less, so it covering lesser distance, that is c2t. Then we take c2t as radius, rho and arc, and then draw the tangential surface. Then draw the tangential surface, and this is the refracted wavefront. And light rays are perpendicular to this wavefront. This angle must be 90. The light rays are perpendicular to this wavefront, and this is c2t. This angle is arc. And take the parallel ray. This is 3 dash, and this is the second ray. Move up to straight line up to this one, and after that it will become parallel to the third ray. This is second, and in this same way the first ray will be there, and after refraction this become parallel to the first dash, second dash, third dash, ray be parallel to each other, and that makes angle R. This is R, this is 90 minus R, because rays are perpendicular to the front. So this angle will be R. So first law be the incident wavefront AB, reflected wavefront A dash B dash are perpendicular to plane of wavefront. So incident ray, reflected ray lie in the plane of paper because rays are perpendicular to wavefront. And this is the first law of reflection. After that, we have to drive the second row. So sine I from this right angle triangle. So sine I, that is the perpendicular upon half-time is. Perpendicular means AA dash, or half-time means BA dash. In the same way, the sine R over from this triangle, the sine R from this triangle, this right angle triangle is again there. So sine R over perpendicular. Perpendicular means this is B and this is B dash. B B dash upon perpendicular upon hypotenuse means B A dash. Divide, this is first and this is second. Divide first by second. First divide by second. So sine I by sine R. So B A dash cancel with B A dash. So kya hoga? A A dash upon B B dash. A dash means C1T upon BP dash means C2T. T cancels with T and that is C1 by C2 and that is the relationship. So second medium with respect to first. It means the sin I upon sin R equal to E. And this is Snell's law. Snell's law for second law of reflection. So second law of reflection. In this way, we can derive laws of reflection on the basis of wave theory.